Hello friends, so today we are going to learn a new concept, that is the interrelationships between the parameters. Now when it requires to find out more than two parameters for a particular network, then it becomes a tedious job. We will have to solve it for, now consider an example where you have to find out Z parameter and Y parameter, both the parameters. So first what you will do, you will first find out Z parameter, then you will again solve it for the Y parameters. So it becomes lengthy and tedious. So there is an interrelation between the parameters, in by which what we can do is, first we will find out a particular parameter, then by using certain relationship or formulas, we will directly get the other parameters. So let's see how to find this interrelationship. Now for your syllabus, there is no any derivation of this interrelationship. Still I will show you one particular interrelationship, and then you can directly refer the table of interrelationship from any book, probably revised. So first we will see how to explain Z parameters in terms of the Y parameters. Here I have written Y parameters, I1, I2 in terms of V1, V2. Now, as you know, this is Y parameter. What is Z parameter? It is V1, V2 in terms of I1, I2, right? Z11, I1 plus Z12, I2, Z21, I1 plus Z22, I2, okay? This is Z parameter. Now what we will do from this equation, let's find out V1. Okay, because V1 is having another equation, Z parameter equation. So how to find out V1? Okay, one can say we can use a Cramer's rule, right? So whenever you be required to find out the V1, replace its coefficient by these constants, use another thing, divide by determinant will give you the particular thing. So by Cramer's rule, V1 is nothing but, replace this coefficient with constant, I1, I2, Y12, Y22, divided by determinant, okay? So it is Y11, Y12, Y21, Y22, okay? So what we can do, we'll express it as I1 into Y22, so that is Y22 I1 minus Y12 I2, right, divided by Y11 Y22 minus Y12 Y21, okay, this is nothing but del Y, determinant, no? So I can write it down as numerator as it is, and denominator I can write determinant as a del Y. Okay, so I will separate the determinant for both terms, and I will get V1 as a V1 equal to, so I can say Y22 by del Y, right? No, yes. So V1 equal to Y22 by del Y I1 minus Y12 by del Y I2. So if you compare this equation, I will say this equation first, with this equation, you can see that it is similar, V1 in terms of I1 into V1 in terms of I1 I2. So if you compare, this term is nothing but Z1. So I can say Z11 equal to Y22 by del Y, and Z12 equal to, is minus, no? Yes, minus Y12 del Y. You got? Now this is the Z parameters in terms of a Y parameter. So if you are having Y parameters, then by doing this thing, you will get directly Z parameter. Similarly, let's find out V2. Okay, so we will have to replace this coefficient with the constant. So V2 equal to, I'll write it down as Y11 I1 Y21 I2 divided by del Y determinant. So it is nothing but Y11 I2 minus Y21 I1 divided by del Y. Okay. So again it is nothing but Y11 by del Y. I will write on I1 first. Okay. So minus Y21 by del Y I1 plus Y11 by del Y I2, right? So if I compare with this equation, it is Z21 is equal to minus y 21 by del y and z 22 equal to plus y 11 by del y. In similar fashion, you can find out interrelationship between any two parameters. Okay, it is very easy in similar fashion. So that you can do by your own. If you forget even in exam, by using these steps, easily we will get interrelationship. Okay, or else you can recite the table of interrelationship. Now let's solve one example. Okay, to see the interrelationship. Okay, so we consider this example from book revising. This is the TI2, 1 ohm, 2 ohm. This is 2 ohm, V1, I1, plus minus V2, I2. Okay, and the question which has been asked is to find Z and Y parameter. Now it's up to you for whether to first find out Z parameter and Y from it, or Y parameter and Z from it. It depended on you, on particularly you. So what we will do, we'll first find out Z parameter. Okay. So because applying KVL is very easy. Now one particular trick is there are four loops. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So what I can do, I will convert this current source and parallel resistance as a voltage source and series resistance to reduce the number of loops. Otherwise, I4 term will be there and then it will become very complicated to solve. So current and resistance parallel will be replaced as a voltage and resistance series. So what will be of voltage source? 3 into 2, 6 volt and resistance in series. And downward is a plus because arrow is like this. So 6 I2 value will be, means only coefficient will be multiplied, I2 will be as it is. Right, V2, V1, 1, 2, this is I1, this is I2, this is 2 ohm. Okay, so let's apply KVL in first loop. It will be V1 equal to I1 minus I3. Okay, this is I1, this is I2, this is I3. Okay, apply KVL in second loop. It is V2 equal to, directly I will write minus 4 I2 plus 2 I3. Okay, apply KVL in third loop. It is, for this if I solve it completely, minus 1 into I3 by I1 minus 2 I3 minus 2 I3 plus I2 plus 6 I2 equal to 0. So solve it for and arrange it for I3 and you will get 5 I3 equal to I1 plus 4 I2. If you rearrange, it is I3 equal to 1 by 5 I1 plus 4 by 5 I2. This is the I3 which you have got. So let's put this I3 in both the equation and directly you will get Z parameters. Okay. Put, this is 3, 1, 2. Put 3 in 1. So it is V1 equal to I1 minus I3, 1 by 5 I1 plus 4 by 5 I2. Okay. When you solve it, you will get it as a 4 by 5 I1 minus 4 by 5 I2 for a V1. Similarly, put 3 in 2 and you will get it as a V2 equal to minus 4 I2 plus 2, 1 by 5 I1 plus 4 by 5 I2. Okay, replaced I3. So when you solve it, you will get V2 equal to 2 by 5 I1 minus 12 by 5 I2. So v1 in terms of i1 i2, v2 in terms of i1 i2. We have got z parameters. So let's write down z11, z12, z221, z22. So z11 is a 4 by 5 minus 4 by 5, 2 by 5 minus 12 by 5. Okay. Now, how to find y parameters from z parameters? Okay, so it is very easy. First of all, let's find out determinant del z. Okay, you can directly get the formula. Del z, that is a z11 into z22 minus z12 into z21. Simple determinant of this. Okay, so z11 means, if I write down 4 by 5 into minus 12 by 5 minus 4 by 5 into 2 by 5 into 2 by 5. So you will get del z as a minus 8 by 5. Okay. Now directly we are having formula y11 equal to z22 by del z. So what is z22 minus 12 by 5? Minus 12 by 5 divided by what is del z? Minus 8 by 5. Minus 8 by 5. Minus minus cancel. 5 by cancel. 12 by 8. Which is nothing but 3 by 2. It is y parameter. We have to write unit as a mho. Admittance parameter. Okay. Similarly, what is y12? y12 it is minus z12 by del z. So what is z12? This is 1, 1, 1, 2. Minus 1, 2. So minus 1 is plus. 4 by 5. Upon minus 8 by 5. So it will be 8 by 4. That is nothing but 4 by 8. 5 by cancel. Minus 4 by 8. So minus 1 by 2. Okay. How to find y21? So for that, forget this. This is not of our interest now. Okay. So y21 is equal to by formula z21 by del z. Now see how easy it is. You have to find out only determinant and then it becomes very easy. Minus z21 by del z. So minus z21 is where it is 2 by 5. So minus 2 by 5 by minus 8 by 5. So minus 1 cancel, 5 by cancel, 1 by 4 more. And last one is y22 equal to z11 by del z. z11 is a 4 by 5, del z is a minus 8 by 5. So minus 4 by 8 is minus 1 by 2. Okay, so this is how you can find out interrelation between any parameter. Now we have seen all the parameters and you are having the formula, so you can see for other parameters also. It is very easy. In next lecture we will see cascade connection and parallel connection of these networks. Thank you.